Hello, and welcome to the vCloud Automation Center video, preparing vCloud Automation Center for NSX integration. In this video, we are going to address the role that reservations play with regards to automated network provisioning, as well as demonstrating the configuration steps required to successfully integrate with NSX. Secondly, we will review the relevant multi-machine blueprint fields that need to be defined for a successful application network deployment before we demonstrate an example configuration of a three-tier application. Reservations are responsible for defining the storage and compute resources that are available to a given business group. Apart from the storage and compute resources, reservations are also responsible for the placement of virtual machines and NSX edge services routers onto the appropriate port group or logical switch. They are also responsible for the request and allocation of network details from the assigned network profile to these virtual machines and edge services routers. Knowing that, there are three key configuration areas that we need to specify within a reservation for dynamic network provisioning: the external network profile to associate with the defined network path, the transport zone that the logical switch and attached edge services routers will be a member of, and the router gateway to which routes will be advertised in the event of using a routed network profile. In this demonstration, we are going to modify an existing reservation. Hover over the reservation required and select Edit. Go to the Network tab, where all network settings will be configured. In this case, the training external network profile has been assigned to a port group called VM traffic. We're going to change that to be associated instead with an NSX logical switch. Secondly, we'll select a transport zone from the available transport zones, in this case, the VCAC transport zone. At this stage, we could also select a security group, which would affect all workloads provisioned into this reservation. This is useful in the event that a particular business group has specific security requirements. Finally, we define a routed gateway to which any routes that we use within a routed network profile can be injected. You may need to work with your NSX administrator to identify the correct interface to assign to the network path. The network profile will be automatically selected. At this point, your reservation configuration is complete. Having defined the network profiles and reservations, the final step is to configure our multi-machine blueprints. You will need to identify one or more single machine blueprints to include as components of the multi-machine blueprint. You'll also need to select the appropriate transport zone information as provided by your NSX administrator. Thirdly, you need to select the network profiles which you wish your multi-machine blueprint components to utilize. And finally, you need to identify any NSX security groups which you wish your blueprint components to inherit security policies from. Once this is done, you are ready to publish your blueprint and make it available within the service catalog for users to provision. In this demonstration, we're going to create a new multi-machine blueprint. Go ahead and enter a name, as well as a useful description. Next, move to our Network tab, and from the drop-down, select the Transport Zone. Next, select a new network profile. In this case, it's going to be for our web tier, so we're going to select a NAT profile. Network profiles can be copied from an existing network profile, or if you have the appropriate permissions, they can be defined on the fly. In this case, we're going to copy from the one-to-one NAT profile. We're going to change the name to be more descriptive as the web tier network relevant to this multi-machine blueprint. The second network profile type we'll select is for our application network, which we wish to be private. This means that no communication from the upstream external network will be able to communicate directly with the application network. Again, we'll copy from the existing defined private network profile, giving it a more descriptive name. Finally, we'll select the database tier network profile. Once again, this needs to be private. As we've already made use of the existing private network profile, we will need to make some modifications to the IP address range that is in use. Firstly, we change the default gateway, and then we edit the range detail to be specific to the database tier within this multi-machine blueprint. Heading over to the Build Information tab, we now add our blueprint component machines. First, we'll edit our web server to define the minimum number to be 3. We'll then edit the network to create a network adapter and associate the defined network profile with it. At this point in time, we'll also add the web tier security group to this machine. Finally, we identify that a load balancer configuration is required on our Edge Services router, and that the virtual IP address will come from the external network profile associated with that edge device. Secondly, we'll edit our database server, adding a network adapter and associating the database tier network we defined earlier, as well as selecting the database security group. Finally, we'll edit our application server network, adding a new adapter and selecting the application tier network configured earlier. We also select the NSX security group that was created and defined earlier by our NSX administrator. The final step is to publish the blueprint so that it can be added to the catalog for users to provision. This completes our Preparing vCloud Automation Center for NSX integration video. For further information, please see our additional videos, Automated Network Provisioning with NSX Overview, which provides the context of the software-defined data center, as well as providing the high-level configuration steps required to integrate vCloud Automation Center and NSX. And secondly, Managing Network Profiles for NSX Integration, where we step through the configuration of network profiles as used within this video. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope that it was informative.